Hey guys, it's Thursday 27th, I believe, of October. Today's going to be Navy SEALs Day, 20-minute session, and here's what I'm going to try to do. Back off down to 5 reps a minute, and to hold that throughout, or at least until the last 2 minutes, and then I might add in some reps to see what I can get. If I make it all the way up to at 5 reps a minute. That's a bit of a change of pace from doing the 6s and 4s. No particular reason I feel the need to back off a bit on my Navy SEALs, but at the same time, keep establishing that base. My happy baseline, of course, is 100 reps in 20 minutes, and I can do that with 6 reps a minute, taking 4 reps a minute breaks throughout, different means of achieving it, you know. And I've gotten up to 107 as my best, and I did that by doing, I believe, 6s and 5s. I don't really remember off the top of my head, but however, I want to reestablish that baseline of 5. So I'll work with 5s in theory. This will be my practice. I'll work with 5s until it's reestablished, and then I'll start adding in 6s at the beginning. So I'll do a minute at 6 reps a minute, and then add on. Eventually get back up to 107 reps. Eventually get to 6 reps a minute all the way across for 120 reps. That's the plan. And as all plans, it's subject to change, depending on how I feel, depending on if it's working. You know, as Dan John says, everything works, but not forever. So I suspect 5s will work for quite a while, and then they won't, and then I'll have to switch and do something else. That's the nature of secular training. Let's get started. I don't want to lose the edge of 6 reps a minute, so I'm going to throw them in, hopefully at least for that last minute. And I want to look as I'm going for opportunities where I could, I might not today, but where I could throw in those 6 reps a minute. We're going to see. Quick sip of water. We're going to see what I have left for that last minute. Hopefully, I'll have enough to get 6 reps a minute for the very last minute, if not the very last 2 minutes. 15 seconds. Here we go. Two. Three.
Two. Three. One. too.
One. Two.
101. On the buzzer. I got that last push up within the time frame. My feet were touching, I was coming up. Technically, we can debate the issue. Should I count it? The way I'm breathing, the way my chest, shoulders, triceps, and core feel, I'm gonna count it. We can debate this in the comment section. I'm always open to debate. I'm always open for critique. was tough, but it was tough only up to a point. Well, I should say, at a certain point, it became tough. I held the 5 reps a minute, averaging 3 reps in the first 30 seconds, 2 reps in the last 30, giving me a little bit of a rest, up until the 14, 15 minute mark, and then became harder. I had less rest. It's that last rest that was eaten into my, not just recovery time, but the time that I would have left and would feel good to blow out some reps near the end. That's what I hope to address. Now, my next Navy SEAL session will probably, I believe, be on Saturday. Here's what I would like to do. 6, 5 across the board. So my first minute, 6 reps a minute, and then settle in to that 5 reps again. What I suspect is maybe I might lose a rep. I might be forced to, just because of time constraint in that minute, as far as rest is concerned, and speed of movement, efficiency of movement, I might be forced to go to 4. If it happens, it happens. I'll do my best to get back up to 5. And that's the key. I'll just do my best. I don't want to get lost within pursuit of reps as an end goal. That 110, breaking 107, getting 110, ultimately 120. Those are nice benchmarks, but that's all they are, benchmarks. Reflection of that day and previous training. The day itself is where the opportunity presents itself, whatever it is. Today it was 101 reps, and it was a solid, volume-producing, non-disappointing 20-minute session. It's hard to top that. Meaning, you know, obviously, you could say 102 reps tops 101 minutes, 101 reps. Counting-wise, it does, but maybe not quality-wise. The key, and this is what Lee Hazard points out all the time, enter the dark place, stay there. Now, here's the thing with the dark place, at least for me, there are infinite ways to approach it, infinite ways to leap into it, and infinite ways to stay there. That it's not all out of breath, huffing and puffing, struggling for air. That's part of it sometimes, but sometimes it's just that deep enduring of pain and repetition and fatigue adding up, rep after rep after rep, knowing that the very next rep, it's going to be just a little bit slightly harder, tougher, than the rep before, and that there's no going back in time. That means no rep is ever going to get easier than the one that you just did. That's the psychological dark place. That's the emotional dark place, and that's the physical dark place. So just stay in there. That's what adds up. Alright, I mentioned wanting to stay on top of the sixes. So we're going to do 6 Navy SEALs, 6 squats, and today is 4-3-2-2-1 pull-ups, I believe. So I'd like to perform the sixes fairly quickly. Of course, you know, if I need to take a breath, I take a breath. Hopefully hopefully that's just enough recovery time. Here's the deal with burpees. My brand new thick yoga mat, extra long, cost a small fortune, is already wearing thin with my feet. Rub. That sucks. Alright, 6 reps. One. Two. Three. Four. Break. Pull-ups after Navy SEALs. This is our joke. Pull-ups after 300 plus push-ups. This is no joke. Really, I want to go back to getting them out of the way. Beginning of the workout. Six reps. Round two. One. Six. Three rounds in. Thank you. by the way. Big shout out to Gus from Gainesboro and Paul from Oregon on their pull-ups and their reps and volume that they're putting in. Incredible. Six reps. Round three. One. Two. Three. Two points. Set of two for the pull-ups. And then it's at one. So this might be, we'll see. This might be my last set of maybe fuels. One.
bag.
They only have one pool left. It's almost a shame to do it without doing the Navy SEALs. And it's almost a shame to do Navy SEALs for only one pool left. Either way. Stuck between a rock and a hard place. You have two choices, they're both crappy. So when you're in that position, what crappy choice is going to give you the most benefit? One. Two. Three. Got my chest, shoulders, triceps. They're pumped. They're shot. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. One pull up. Hang from the bar. A couple knee raises after my rep. Solid session. Nothing spectacular, but it's the kind of session that you walk away from knowing that you finished what you set out to do, that you met the agenda of the workout, you met the agenda of the day. For whatever reason, what came to mind for me right now was purpose and Dharma. Dharma is a Sanskrit word that could be interpreted many different ways, as most Sanskrit words can be. An example is the word karma, which we in the West have mistaken for punishment. We even think of it as cause and effect. But really, cause and effect is a dualistic simplicity of its expression. Because the effect happens, or let's say the cause happens as soon as the effect does. It ripples out. It's like dropping a pebble into a still pond. And even more so, it's like an invisible hand dropped a pebble
into the pond, or an unseen hand, that it's really just effect, 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 effect. We think of ourselves as nouns when we're better expressed as a verb, as a process, continuously happening in some sense. That's why when I say there is no self, I don't mean there isn't a personality, there isn't an appearance of a self. I mean that there's no solid, lasting entity that is a self. It's always an ongoing program, an ongoing product of what's occurred previously, what's occurring now, everything just rippling out from that unseen pebble dropped in the stillness of our beingness. So back to Dharma. Dharma can sort of be expressed as the way or teaching or purpose, why we're here, the meaning that we're here. And in the sense of this conversation, that's what we're going to use it for. That every session has a Dharma, a purpose of its own. Every rep has a Dharma, a purpose of its own. And it's all expressed within the perimeters that are set, the perimeters of a 20-minute workout or 20-minute set, an hour-long workout. We don't always know what that Dharma is, only because we don't always take the time to listen, most especially in a 20-minute set when you don't want to pause and ask each repetition, what is your purpose? What is your Dharma? The thing is, those reps will be expressed on their own by the action, by the doing, just by allowing them to be expressed. And we can get in tune with that, not by continuously pausing and listening, but by trusting the rep, trusting our intuition of what we should do, what should be done. And that happens through, I'll use, this is a point of contention with a lot of people, Malcolm Gladwell's 10,000 hours to anything to be perfected. You know, for someone like Mozart, he didn't need 10,000 hours of practice at the piano. He, in all possibility, could have had 1,000 lifetimes to get to that point. But he did need to practice, and he did practice. And we get to that point by the 10,000 reps that we do. Or sometimes, you know, this is the case of Satori, Zen enlightenment. One rep done perfectly and then remembered. And we don't remember it consciously in our brain. It's remembered by ourselves. It's remembered by our molecules. It's remembered by the atoms and by the particles. It's remembered by the essence of who we are, deeply ingrained. Nothing ever expressed is wasted. Again, it has that continuous effect. So those reps add up. You know, we hear the practice makes perfect, but really it's perfect practice makes for perfection. That was hard for me to say. So again, it's not attempting to make those reps perfect, each and every one. It's trusting that it will be perfect if we get out of the way, if we don't overthink it, if we just act. That's the lesson of the Bhagavad Gita, is action. If it could be summed up in one easy paragraph, I was going to say word, but I can't do it in a single word, let alone maybe even a sentence or a paragraph. But it can be aptly summed up by trusting your action, trusting your Dharma. Each workout has its own Dharma. Go down to your basement, go to your loft of gains, go to your kitchen, go to your backyard, wherever you do your burpees, wherever you do your workout, and simply trust that each rep will be cared for. Each rep is supported by the universe, and that you are no less than the universe itself. So everything works perfectly, seamlessly, and those reps just, they come as they do. And that's how it happens. That's sometimes the best that we can hope for. The reps come as they do. And we walk away from the session with a big smile on our face. With that being the case, I'm going to walk away from this session with a big smile on my face. This is about as big as my smile gets. So I'll leave it at that. I'll say goodbye to everyone, and I'm looking forward to seeing what routines you put up today. Thanks a lot. Take care, guys. Bye.